All right, this is fifth grade, module 5, lesson 18. And in this lesson, we're continuing to classify two-dimensional figures, specifically quadrilaterals. Today, we're going to be focusing on rectangles and rhombuses to talk about the differences between those things and what they are. And basically, what a rhombus is, it's a quadrilateral where all four sides have the same length. Now that sounds like it's a square, right? Quadrilateral where all four sides are the same length. Ah, but a square has 90 degree angles, where a rhombus does not necessarily need to have all four angles being, or having the angles being 90 degrees. It just, the only requirement for a rhombus is that it's a quadrilateral where all four sides are the same length. Rectangle, more familiar for most of our fifth graders, which is it's a quadrilateral with four right angles. That's the definition of a rectangle. Now, so oftentimes we say two of the lines are parallel, the other two are parallel, these two are equal, and these two are equal. But that's extra information that we don't have to include. And so a rectangle is a quadrilateral with four right angles. A rhombus is a quadrilateral where all four sides are the same length. So let's get started on this.
So we're being asked to draw a rhombus with no right angles. Now remember what a rhombus is. It's got to have four equal sides. And so let's get a slightly thicker pen. And a rhombus where it's got four equal sides. So I'm going to draw this that way. And in order to make it have the equal length, it's got to go that way, and then here, and then here. Now, is that the only possible rhombus that we can create? No, there's others that we could have done, but that's the one I'm going to draw. And I know it's a rhombus because all four sides are the same length. And I happen to win because there are no right angles. Now, question B says, now draw a rhombus where you do have four right angles. And of course, this is going to look like, now it's not easy because the lines, we kind of have to go against the lines. But what I'm trying to draw is a square. Now, how do I know it's a rhombus? Well, it's a rhombus because it has four sides that are all equal to each other. Now, I also happened to draw it so that it had four right angles because that's what it asked for. So next one, down here, a rectangle with not all sides being equal. So what would a rectangle look like if not all of the sides are equal? Well, here's a rectangle. Now, what was the rule for, how do I know it's a rectangle? Well, I know it's a rectangle because it has four 90-degree angles. That's the only requirement for it to be a rectangle. But I did the added benefit of saying that, showing, drawing a picture where they're not all the same side lengths. In fact, this left side is equal to this right side, and the top base is equal to the bottom base, and that satisfies this, where they're not all sides are equal. Now here it says, draw a rectangle where all sides are equal. So I know that all angles have to be 90 degrees because that's a rectangle. But now I have to draw all four sides being the same. Well, what is that going to be? Something with all 90 degree angles. That makes it a rectangle. And the fact that all sides are equal, boom, 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 and boom, makes it a square. Means it's a square. Now here it says, a rhombus has a perimeter of 217 centimeters. What is the length of each side of the rhombus? So the idea is, well, let's start with a rhombus. And we know that the perimeter is 217. So that means if we were to add this side plus this side plus this side plus this side, we would get 217. Now, the rule for it being a rhombus is that all four sides are equal. So if we know the perimeter is 217, we could divide by 4 to figure out the length of each one of those sides. And I get remainder of 1, so that's going to be 54 1/4. So each side is 51 1/4 centimeter. In the last slide, I'm going to do something a little bit different. It says list all the properties that rhombuses share, right? Well, I want you to go to this website, tube.geogebra.org/m/58635. So you got to do everything correctly. And I know it works because I just checked it. And I just want you to play with this applet. Basically, it allows you to dynamically play with a rhombus and look at all of the characteristics of a rhombus and the properties and just play. Same thing down here with rectangles. It's a different URL. tube.geogebra.org/m/54810. And just play. Basically, parents and teachers, what we're going to be looking for is for a rhombus, we're looking for 4 equal sides. 4 equal sides. We're going to be looking for students to talk about the diagonals, that they're equal, they're not equal diagonals, that the diagonals don't have to be equal, but the diagonals are bisected. And remember what that means. That means each diagonal is cut in half by the other diagonal, right? Cut into 2 pieces, equal pieces. And there's other things we could put in that list. We're going to have opposite angles being equal. We're going to talk about consecutive angles are going to have a sum of 180. There's a bunch of things that students might say. Same thing down here. There's a lot of different properties, but we're specifically going to be looking for 90-degree angles. For 90-degree angles, we're going to be looking at parallel sides. We're going to want to hear that opposites are parallel. So the opposites are parallel. There's a variety of other properties that students might say. So we just want them to play with these 2 URLs and come up with their list. And it's perfectly fine if their list is incomplete. What's more important is to allow students to play with the GeoGebra, the dynamic geometry software. And that wraps up 5th grade Module 5, Lesson 18, focusing on rectangles and rhombuses.